made my mark as a new age piano player, kind of a phrase coined by the record labels back in the 80s. And through the 90s, I became pretty well known for a very romantic style of music. Experimenting along the way, working with orchestras, doing some work with Paul Spear, kind of doing a kind of a rock edge to the music, and then as time went on, the flavor du jour became smooth jazz, sometimes referred to as safe sax. In the back of my mind, and I think probably for some of the hardcore fans, they really wanted me to go back to the beautiful, as my brother used to say.
What you did on Blue Largo. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're going to remember the intro and all the little twists and turns.
Yeah. Well, I'm a child of, you know, great songwriting like Paul McCartney and John Lennon, so that just comes naturally to me now. I'm always looking for, to me, that's kind of the meat of a song. You know, it's the little hook, it's that melody that hopefully you remember.
See, Wesley thought it was going to be, like he calls me, the spirit and you romance. And he thought the bringing together the spirituality of the I guess, indigenous chants mm-hmm. from lost cultures with this signature David Lanz right. pianistic. Will fuse these two things together. But what happened was... I had recently gotten these beautiful bamboo Chinese flutes that were, quote, more in tune and had more capabilities for your style of piano.
Hold it.
Let me go in on that, where that hole is.
What hole?
Just where the piano takes over just for a second.
Okay.
The end? Yeah. Yeah, 3 or 4 years ago, Doug and I were in the Toledo airport. We had the long hair and the coats and stuff. And this beautiful woman walked up. She goes, "I know who you guys are. You're Siegfried and Roy."